everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another average value of the function problem. And the function that we're given is h of x equals cosine to the 4x, well, to the 4th x times sine of x on the range 0 to pi. So the formula that we're going to be using for the average value is 1 over b minus a, which gives us the average part on the range of the function, and we're going to be integrating on the limits of integration a to b. In this case, they've given us our range, a to b. It's 0 to pi. So 0 is a and pi is b. And the first thing that we're going to do is plug in our limits of integration 0 and pi. So again, we're plugging in pi for b, as you can see here, and 0 for a. And then we also plug them in as our limits of integration here. And we take our function, h of x, and put it into the integral here. So that sets us up. And now it's a matter of simplifying so that we can get to a point where we can integrate. So obviously pi minus 0 out in front here just becomes pi. I'm going to, even though it's not really technically correct, the best way to write cosine to the 4th of x is as it's written here in the integral. It's easier to work with it for me. When I move it outside, I can just see cosine of x, and it's all raised to the 4th power, which is still technically correct, but the best way to write it is with the fourth after the cosine. But the reason I'm going to do this is because this problem is going to require us to use u substitution to solve the integral, and we're going to substitute u for cosine of x, so it's easier to have this fourth out here for me. So we're going to set u equal to cosine of x, and the reason that we pick cosine of x instead of sine of x is because, remember, when we're doing u substitution, we find u, and then we take the derivative, du, and the derivative of cosine of x is negative sine of x, which might allow us to cancel out this sine of x here. So that's what I'm hoping for, and that's why I picked cosine of x to be u. So we set u equal to cosine of x, and then we take the derivative of u, du, and the derivative of cosine of x is negative sine of x. So we have negative sine of x dx here. We always write the dx here when we take the derivative du. And then we're going to solve for dx by dividing both sides by negative sine of x. And when we do that, we'll get dx equal to du divided by negative sine of x. And now that we've done that, what we're going to do is put in du over negative sine x for dx and u for cosine of x. And hopefully that'll allow us to simplify the integral. So you can see that we've put u in here for cosine of x, and here's our fourth power. And we put du over negative sine of x in for dx. And as you can see, we are going to get these two sine of x terms here to cancel. We're just going to have to pull out this negative 1 in the denominator out in front. So this negative 1 is going to come out in front of the integral here. So we'll end up with negative 1 over pi. And then we'll have sine of x in the numerator and in the denominator, which will cancel. And we're just left with u to the fourth du in the integral, which is really easy to integrate. So when we integrate, we'll have this negative 1 over pi, which stays out in front. And we, as always with integration, add 1 to the exponent. So 4 plus 1 gives us 5. And then we divide the coefficient, which is this implied 1 here, by the new exponent, 5. So we get a 1/5 coefficient out in front of the u. And then we'll be evaluating from 0 to pi. So before we can evaluate, we have to plug back in for u. So remember that we said u was equal to cosine of x. So we plug cosine of x back in for u. And while we're at it, we move the fifth power back in front of the x here on the cosine, because that's the best technically correct way to write it. So we plugged back in for u, and now we'll evaluate from 0 to pi. So the first thing that we'll do is plug in pi here to 1/5 cosine of the fifth of x. We plug in pi here. Then we subtract, and then we plug in 0. Whenever we're evaluating like that definite integral, we plug in the top number, which was pi, so we do that first. Then we always subtract here in the center, and then plug in our bottom number, which was 0. So we plug that in, and now we're going to start simplifying. Cosine to the fifth of pi, basically you're looking at cosine of pi, and what you need to do is grab your unit circle. Cosine of pi will be the angle along the x-axis. And at pi, at the angle pi, you're looking for the x-coordinate, because when we're evaluating cosine of an angle on the unit circle, we look at the x-coordinate. Sine of an angle on the unit circle has us look at the y-coordinate. So we're looking at the x-coordinate, and along the x-axis there, the x-coordinate is equal to negative 1. So we plug in negative 1 for cosine of pi, and we keep our fifth power here on the negative 1. And then cosine of 0, again looking at the unit circle, we'll be looking at the place where the angle is equal to 0, and cosine of that angle, again, is the x-coordinate at that point, which is 1. So cosine of 0 is 1. We keep our fifth power. And now negative 1 to the fifth is negative 1. So we have a negative 1 times 1 fifth gives us a negative 1 fifth here for this first term. And 1 to the fifth power is simply 1. So we have a negative 1 fifth times 1 stays a negative 1 fifth. So when we combine everything inside the parentheses, negative 1 fifth minus another 1 fifth gives us a negative 2 fifths here. And now it's simple enough that we can combine these two. Because we have a negative times a negative, we get a positive 2 over 5 pi. And that is our final answer. So that's the average value of this function, h of x, over the range 0 to pi. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!